startling ABC News investigation. A whistleblower has come forward to tell consumers about the ground beef a lot of us buy at the supermarket. Is it what we think it is, or is it padded with a filler the whistleblower calls pink slime? ABC's senior national correspondent Jim Avila set out to get answers.
Gerald Zernstein grinds his own hamburger these days. Why? Because this former USDA scientist, now whistleblower, knows that 70% of the ground beef we buy at the supermarket contains something he calls pink slime. Beef trimmings that were once used only in dog food and cooking oil, now sprayed with ammonia to make them safe to eat, and then added to most ground beef as a cheaper filler. It was Zernstein who, in a USDA memo, first coined the term pink slime, and is now coming forward to say he won't buy it.
It's economic fraud. It's not fresh ground beef. It's a substitute. It's a cheap substitute being added in.
Zernstein and his fellow USDA scientist Carl Custer both warned against using what the industry calls lean, finely textured beef, and is widely known now as pink slime. But their government bosses overruled them.
Why didn't you consider it beef? Because it was a salvage product. Leftover fat that had been heated at low temperature and the excess fat spun out.
Here's how it's done. Those waste trimmings are gathered, simmered at low heat to make it easier to separate fat from muscle, put in a centrifuge and spun to finish the separation. Next, the mixture is sent through pipes where it's sprayed with ammonia gas to kill bacteria, and finally compressed into bricks and flash frozen for shipment to meatpackers and grocery stores where it's added to most ground beef. And it doesn't have to appear on the label, because over objections of its own scientists, USDA officials with links to the beef industry labeled pink slime meat.
The undersecretary said, it's pink, therefore it's meat.
ABC News has learned the woman who made the decision to okay the mix is former Undersecretary of Agriculture Joanne Smith, a call that led to hundreds of millions of dollars for Beef Products, Inc., the makers of pink slime. When Smith stepped down from USDA, BPI's principal supplier appointed her to the board of directors, where she made at least $1.2 million over 17 years. She did not return our calls for comment. BPI says it had nothing to do with her appointment, and the USDA says, while legal then, under current ethics rules, she could not have immediately joined that board. Jim Avila, ABC.
We are back on the case tonight, our ABC News investigation of the filler called pink slime in 70% of the ground beef sold at supermarkets in this country. You have flooded us with emails about your attempts to get direct answers from your supermarkets. Which ones allow it? Which ones don't? And what does the beef industry have to say? ABC senior national correspondent Jim Avila went right to the top to get answers.
This is ours. This is fresh.
Organic butchers like Brooklyn's Joshua Applestone have a strict definition of 100% fresh ground beef.
This should be whole muscle ground, made into a patty and put into a freezer.
Applestone says he wouldn't sell or serve his family hamburger mixed with lean, finely textured beef, commonly known as pink slime, something that's in 70% of American ground beef. This picture of the material was sent to ABC News by its maker today. That's the final product that starts with low-grade beef trimmings, spun in machines, and spritzed with ammonia.
It's an unnatural process.
But most Americans get their ground beef at supermarkets, and our viewers want to know if pink slime lurks in the beef sold here.
About 30% of meat doesn't contain pink slime.
Which retail chains carry it?
So for the second day in a row, we asked America's top 10 grocers and Whole Foods exactly that. These companies either didn't respond or had no comment. The owners of Stop and Shop and Giant say they use the product. Safeway would only say the government says the filler is safe, but they're reviewing their own policy. These stores say their beef contains no pink slime at all.
Is that additive up to our standards? The answer is no. I personally don't know how I could explain to a Costco member that we put trim that's been treated with ammonia in their ground beef.
Critics say pink slime is more like gelatin than beef and less nutritious. But BPI, its inventor and primary manufacturer, tells ABC News in a letter from its lawyer today, it is USDA-approved beef and is nutritious And the American Meat Institute insists pink slime is not an additive, so no label is necessary.
What's being hidden here?
What are you asking me to put on the label? It's beef. It's on the label. It's a beef product. It says beef. This is beef. So we are declaring it. It's beef.
What about the government in all this, Jim? USDA?
We've been asking the USDA since Wednesday for an interview on camera. They've said no, and they're not changing their policy. They didn't give us no indication they're changing their policy.